Hello, this is Athena Lemon from the Wolbachia Project, and today we're talking about Lab 2, DNA extraction. DNA is a really cool double-stranded molecule that is the blueprint for everything that's living. I think it's so cool that there are four different nucleotides or bases, A, T, C, G, and by changing the arrangement, we are different than the bugs that we study. You can even barcode an arthropod by looking at the sequence of these bases and find out exactly what genus and species the arthropod is. But to do that, first we need to extract DNA from the arthropod. Let's talk about where we can find the DNA in our arthropod sample. Let's take this fruit fly, for example. We know that DNA is in the cells of this fruit fly. So if we look at a cell zoomed in, here's the nucleus where there's genomic DNA, the chromosomes, and then there's also mitochondria. And mitochondria actually have that gene that I was talking about, that barcoding gene, where you can differentiate different species of arthropods from the sequence in their mitochondria. Finally, because this is the Wolbachia Project, we're interested in extracting Wolbachia DNA. Wolbachia is a bacteria that lives inside of the arthropod cell, so anytime we extract Wolbachia DNA, we will also be extracting arthropod DNA. Wolbachia is concentrated in the reproductive organs of the arthropod, so we'll be focusing on the abdomen, where the reproductive organs are located, when we prepare a sample. To prepare for DNA extraction, we want to make the process as easy as possible and give ourselves the best chance of success to detect if Wolbachia is there, if it is there. To do that, if your sample, if your arthropod, is the size of a grain of rice or smaller, like fruit flies or ants or mosquitoes, you do not need to dissect your arthropod. However, if your arthropod is larger than a grain of rice, like a grasshopper or a firefly, or if it has a hard coating, like a ladybug or a pill bug, you do need to find out where the reproductive organs are and dissect them out in order to have the best chance of success. My favorite method is to isolate where I think the reproductive organs are, open the shell, and scoop the goop. It's pretty obvious there's more to cells than just DNA. There's proteins, salts, and lipids, in addition to a bunch of other things. We need to clean all of that off from the DNA and just have clean DNA for our sample. So let's get started with the process of DNA extraction. The first step of DNA extraction is lysis, to break open. We not only want to break open the arthropod cell, but the organelles inside of the cell and any Wolbachia bacteria that's inside the cell. The very first thing we're going to do is mechanical lysis by using this pestle to really grind your arthropod. This is the most important part of the lysis step, and if you didn't get results at the end of the project, you probably didn't grind your arthropod enough, especially if it has an exoskeleton. After you're done grinding for at least a minute, a full 60 seconds, then we're going to add proteinase K, which is an enzyme that digests protein. After that, we'll add a lysis solution, which is a detergent to break open and disrupt the cell membranes. To give everything the optimal chance to work, we're going to heat up that lysis mixture for at least 15 minutes. We get best results with at least an hour, but it should work with 15 minutes. After lysis, the next step is precipitating the DNA. We'll do this by adding ethanol. DNA is not soluble in ethanol. If you're using a column-based kit, now you would add that entire mixture to the column and pull it through the column with the help of a centrifuge. The DNA will only bind to the membrane on the column and let everything else pass. However, there are still some impurities in the DNA, some extra salts that we need to remove before we have clean DNA. So we're going to wash our DNA. We do that by adding wash buffers that are pulled through that column and rinse through the membrane, leaving the DNA in place, but rinsing all of the extra salts off of it. Once you wash your DNA a few times, you're ready to elute your DNA. Now that your DNA is clean and free of impurities, it's time to elute your DNA. We do that by adding a solution that the DNA is soluble in. You need to give it a minute or so for the DNA to actually dissolve back into the elutant solution and off of the column. After that, you pull it through with a centrifuge, and what you have in the bottom of your tube is your clean DNA ready to be used. You might notice if you had a lot of exoskeleton in your original sample that some of that pigment wasn't completely removed by the purification process. And therefore, your elutant, your DNA that you get out at the end, might be orange or yellow or even gray. That's okay, your DNA is still ready to use. No matter what color your DNA elutant is, store it in the freezer until our next lab. I'll see you next time for Lab 3, PCR. Thank you.